beautiful Sagittarian friends, and welcome to your horoscope for February 2020, where the month is going to continue on, at least for the first handful of days, with a pumped amount of energy in your sign. I hope, Sagittarius, you've been enjoying the energy of Mars in your sign. Sometimes it can be a lot and you're over there with like 6 cups of coffee, you know, or your mind just feels like it won't settle down, just tingles through the body. So I hope that Mars in his transit through your sign has been helping you, giving you some energy, giving you some motivation. He'll still be there until we get to the 16th of the month. So enjoy that energy. Enjoy using you, putting yourself out there, using that personal independence to get things done and move some things forward. Now, the big news of the month is that Mercury is going to be going retrograde in the energy of Pisces. Then it will retrograde back into the energy of Aquarius. And at 28 degrees, it will come out direct in the energy of Aquarius on March 10th. So that's the stuff that the month has kind of got our mind wrapped around. Now, why I want to really focus in on the Mercury retrograde as well, and I want to bring it to your attention, is because in the general reading, which these are general readings, what we know is that, first of all, your midheaven up here has Virgo up there, which is ruled by Mercury. So we know if Mercury is making any kind of move, that particular area is going to be stimulated as well, right? It's like a guitar. When you strum the string, everything on that string that is of the same vibration will get a little bit of a shake, right? Now, as well, you've got a seventh house over here in Gemini, also ruled by the energy of Mercury. So there will be some shifts of energy that happen there as well as Mercury is in the retrograde energy. So I'll show you what I mean as I pull it together. Let's jump in here and talk about this month and see what's on the cosmic landscape. Now, one thing I want to bring your attention to as well is if you look, the bottom part of the chart is where the majority of the energy is happening here. So as that's blowing through the bottom part of the chart, it tells us you're getting prepared in foundational level ways. These are not always as public, right? Maybe something that you've been working on in this particular area is energy that you're going to be moving later out into the world. We've got a moon that's going to happen up here. So something you've been working on, you've been creating, you've had your hands on, now you're going to be able to put it out there. But for the most part, things are happening at a foundational level, which means not everybody can see them. Maybe family is important. Maybe getting a new foundation is something you're definitely working on. Sagittarius, I don't know how many of you had a year last year that was a little bit, it felt a little harsh, or it felt like there was a lot of struggle, lessons that maybe they you know today that they were just disguised, but they were good lessons. That means you've got perfect ground, perfect fertile ground to build a new foundation.
So okay? As we get here at the beginning of the month on the 3rd, we see Mercury, who's been traveling in the energy of Aquarius. That, along with having Mars in your sign, there's been a lot of hyperactivity, right? I feel like your body has probably, especially as a fire energy, I feel like you probably took very well to that air energy of Mercury here. Lots of thinking, lots of ideas. It's been working in your 3rd house, so lots of content creation as well, right? Maybe ideas, maybe a book, maybe a painting, maybe photography, the website, whatever it is, you have been stimulated and in motion. Now on the 3rd, Mercury's got to move on, and he's going to move into the energy of Pisces, lighting up your 4th house space. So a couple things to keep in mind here. First of all, Mercury is our planet of communication, decision making, sharing information, details, facts and specific details, right? So when he moves into the energy of Pisces, who's very watery and is happy to be vague, happy to move around the details, Mercury is not comfortable. We say he's in fall in this position, which means he is not in full power at all. The planet has to get on board and get things done with the characteristics of the sign that it is in, whether it likes it or it doesn't like it. So what do you do when you're thinking, making the best decision of your life, planet is not in a comfortable position to do what he does best? You've got to be Piscean. Trust your intuition, trust your dreams, trust your visions. Listen in this world. Listen with empathy to the people around you. Listen with empathy to your own heart and your own mind. Listen with empathy between the worlds in your meditations and things like that. Logic is not the stuff that dreams are made of this month. It's just not. And especially in the 4th house, this is the house of home, family, real estate, property, women in your life, a psychological foundation. Here, you're going to have to trust something that's in between the worlds to guide you to what's next or guide you towards what needs your attention. It's this beautiful exchange of words that are sometimes not even said that acts as an entry point for you to begin making changes here, right? So logic is not going to be where you're going to be working to work with the fourth house area. So what does this bring into you? Mercury here. You could have lots of conversations going on with your family or lots of conversations or you're making lots of decisions around home, maybe around a family member or something. If you work from home, this could just be a very busy time. You could have a lot coming in or you maybe even feel like, I need to withdraw a little bit and pay attention to some foundational level things. I need to withdraw just a little bit at home in some way, shape, or form. So you could watch for that to be happening. But I also think that this brings spiritual conversations and empathy and healing into your home life, into your relationships with women, whatever that happens to look like. Now, keep in mind that Mercury is also a ruler of this career energy, also a ruler of this relationship energy in the general. So what we know is that in your career, work in the place of intuition, work in the place of maybe it feels intangible, you can't really touch it, but it's a guiding energy for you, and that's how you will succeed at work. It will be the same principles of how you will succeed in your relationship. Empathy and listening will be your greatest gifts that you can take to expand those areas and to advance those areas as well, okay? On the 7th, Venus is moving on. She's going to move into the energy of Aries, where Venus is also not comfortable over there. Venus wants harmony and everybody wins and let's take our time, you know what I mean? And Aries is like, no now, and I win, right? It's the energy of I. It's very assertive. Aries is also happy to have a little bit more conflict than Venus is willing to have, right? But the planet has to get on board getting things done like the sign that they are in. So Venus in Aries here, first of all, she becomes very impulsive. Venus likes to bring love and likes to bring money to the table, right? So Venus moving into Aries, you could find yourself being impulsive. In the 5th house, this is the house of romance. This is the house of play. This is the house of pleasure. Yes, thank you very much. I would not be surprised if a surprise infatuation comes to your table. Or even if it's someone you've been around for a long time, you're like, you know what, I thought about it and I like you, let's do this. You could find yourself being very, very impulsive, love at first sight, no strings attached kind of situation. So if that blows into your life, I'm not saying don't go for it. I'm saying be mindful of keeping your heart protected. Your logic energy is not on, okay? So, and you know what? Sometimes we just need a nice little soulful, intuitive, delicious connection to come into our lives to remind us of pleasure. Maybe this is a time with Venus and Aries you're reminding yourself of pleasure. What do you do that is creative and soulful and brings you pleasure? And it's the kind of pleasure where you get to express yourself. Are you playing with the kids? Are you spending time here? If you want to make a baby, this is wonderful energy. And maybe making a baby looks like starting a new business. Venus is going to bring magnetism, relationship, money into this particular area for you. And she's not afraid in Aries to be very direct and say, this is what I want. This is what I'm trying to create. It recognizes at a soulful level that I need to ask for what I want in this particular area. So you can see Venus bringing all kinds of goodies to this 5th house area, but just know it will be highly, highly magnetic for sure. On the 9th, we're going to have a full moon happening in the energy of Leo. Now, this is going to be up here in your 9th house space. This has been busy. You had Mercury here. You've had the Sun here. This has been a motivated third house area. So the aspect that happens when we have a full moon is the Sun and the Moon are in opposition to each other, right? So something's happening down here, and I'm trying to get something to happen up here. So maybe with this full moon, which says, all right, Sag, we need to end something, acknowledge something, or make an adjustment here. I'm going to bring a shift of energy in, is what this Leo moon says. And it's going to be about your originality, your self-expression, your creativity. It's above the horizon line. You're not hiding. Maybe you did something creative. You finally wrote those poems. You did the book. You wrote the computer program or a data program. You did your first digital software layout, right? Whatever it is, publishing, marketing, broadcasting, that's what's happening as the ninth house is stimulated. So you're expanding out beyond where you were at before, and we can see you. So did you publish that book? Did you publish that video? Did you publish that website? Did you do that dissertation, right? Is this the time where you're like, I've done the studying, now I'm ready to make that bigger. I finished college, I'm looking towards my master's degree. You know what? I've been studying Portuguese for 7 years. I'm ready to travel, right? So whatever it is, Sag, you're ready to expand that thing out. The other thing on the third, ninth axis I want to bring your awareness to is what I started the video with. At this point in the year, Sag, I think you have a different understanding, a more faithful understanding, a higher level understanding that the things that were changing down here for you last year were blessings in disguise. They literally were your nuggets of gold pointing you forward as to where you needed to change, adjust, mature, or whatever it looks like. So in your thinking houses, I think this also tells us that your new thinking, your new belief is expanded and you understand what's happening different. And if you can understand, you can have less fear and you can move forward a lot more faithfully, right? Sagittarius, you're a joyful, enthusiastic, optimistic energy. So I think when we get your understanding in alignment as well, there's so much freedom for you there. I have a Sagittarian kid. I know when her joy level is low, it's like the rest of it is bust. So I happen to believe that's the same for some of you as well. When we get to the 16th, Mars is moving out of your sign, which for some of you, you're like, yes, go, please. Take your overthinking and overactive body over there. But it will mean that your energies and your movements are going to move differently now. Now your second house, which is already a house of power for you this year, becomes stimulated and ready to do stuff. Mars in the energy of Capricorn, they love each other. This planet is comfortable, okay? Because Mars loves to do stuff and he's boots on the ground. He's not just bringing you energy, you're moving. You're in action with Mars. Capricorn loves to achieve. So because the planet's got to act like the sign's characteristics, Capricorn gives Mars this structure and he says, we've got these resources to use. Let's talk to these people. Let's make these investments. And Mars is like, let's do it, right? So they get busy moving together. So your second house becomes a house of power and is stimulated as we get to the 16th of the month. So you could, this is a phenomenal energy for you to make an investment, right? Whatever the investment is, it may even be a little bit of a risk. You're a risk-taking kind of energy. This is a good energy, especially before Mercury goes retrograde. And if and when Mercury goes retrograde, you might be going back to an investment idea. Maybe you want to have an investment property, and it doesn't mean that you necessarily buy it or get it. Maybe you're taking the classes on how to invest financially to be able to do that. Mars is going to bring that here. If you're looking to make more money, Mars in this particular area is going to show you how to take your skills and your talents and put them out there and bring back a profit. The other thing I think a lot about with this second house being so busy for you this month is the fact that Mars in Capricorn is going to ask you, are you in charge of your money or is your money in charge of you? And the answer to that has got to get sorted out, because if your money's going all over the place and you don't know where it's at, if you can't account for every dime that comes in and goes out of your house, use this. Look at that. Learn about that. Help yourself here, right? This is a matter of control a little bit. Use your resources wisely. The other thing that is important about Mars in the second house is that it does want success for you. It does want success for you here, okay? All right, when we get to the 17th of the month, Mercury, who's come over here into this beautiful energy of Pisces, roaming around the fourth house, is going to go into its retrograde. Okay, so it's going to start the retrograde here, then it'll move back to the third house. So, but as we start this retrograde here in the fourth house, one of the things to consider is during a retrograde, we go back, we revisit, revise, reconnect, re-edit, re-evaluate this particular area of our lives. So with Mercury being here, because it's not pure on logic, you may be re-looking at your connection with your home. Do you feel like your home is a reflection of a space that feels comfortable and delicious to you, right? Is it intuitive to move through your home? Do you feel like you live in the place that you should live? Pisces and energy might be telling you, hey, this is not the right area for us. We're not going to be successful. Your connections with people in your home, you may again be dipping into that empathy, being more sensitive to other people in your home so you can hear what they need for you, from you. Or maybe you're asking for what you need in your home. But this is a great energy between the two of these, and especially during this retrograde, to reconsider this area of your life and what maybe needs to be adjusted, because Mercury is going to take you right back to it. Because it's the fourth house, a retrograde could always take us back to the grandma or the grandpa or to the ancestry or relationships from the past, or, oh man, I remember I loved living in this place. And what is your connection that you have to that? What is that trying to tell you or teach you? So those could be things that come to your table as well, okay? On the 19th, we've got the sun coming over with all of this excitement of the retrograde, Neptune there as well, into the energy of Pisces in your fourth house. The sun is motivated. It's light, heat, life, and vitality. So you are motivated here. You want to live. You want this area to be vital. Vital means I need it to live, right? So you want essence and vitality happening here. So I do think that this makes you more compassionate. You could even be taking somebody into your house or caring for someone in your house from your past, or maybe a family relation has had to come back. If it's you that needs to go back and be in a family member's house, I think you're doing that quite graciously as well. So those are things to keep on your mind, but the sun is making you vital here. You want this area to live and to live well and be healthy, so you're active in it, okay? On the 20th, we've got a cool aspect I want to show you because it's one of progress. So we've got Jupiter who's here in Capricorn, and he's going to come into a sextile. Even if my marker is dying, he's going to come into a sextile with Neptune who's over in your fourth house, okay? A sextile means when the planets have sex, that's good for us. It's a pocket of opportunity for you to do something with ease. But because it's a sextile, it's not just the opportunity like a trine, but you're in motion and in action to take advantage of this. Now, as Jupiter and Neptune come together, your second and your fourth houses are houses of power right now. You can see they're the busiest, right? So these two areas are working together, and you will make progress by taking advantage of an opportunity here, but you progress faster than you would at any other time of the year. What happens is, I think in this sextile, especially because Mercury is retrograde in Piscean energy, what happens is you have to go back to something in this fourth house area. You have to relook at the home zone. You have to relook at the connection with a woman. You have to relook at working from home. Can you do that? Is that a reality? But whatever it is, you're looking back over it so that you can make it profitable, so that you can see the value that it has going forward. For some people, what it's going to be is honestly looking back at childhood and seeing the value that it has to you now. You may have had whatever experience you had, good, bad, or indifferent, in your childhood, in your house, in your upbringing. Maybe even because this is coming over some Aquarian energy as well, it's a cause, or it's an idea, or an event, or a history, something from the past, and you know how to put it out there and make that valuable, or you see the value that it adds to your life. But overall, whatever it is, this is an avenue of success. This is an aspect of success, but you've got to look back at it in order to move it forward. The other thing that happens when Jupiter and Neptune come together is we have to define our ideals. For you, what is a healthy financial life? What are your ideals around that? What's a healthy home life? What are your ideals around that? If you can define your ideals, you can know if you're meeting them. You can't know if this area of your life is successful if you haven't defined any ideals here that are yours, not the one that society says, right? Does society say that your home life needs to look like this, this, and this, but that's not what's in your heart? That's not what feels right for your rotation, right? What are your ideals in this area? Define them so that you know what to progress forward to, okay? All right, as we end this month, we've got a very busy fourth house, and it's going to cook up a little bit more because we're going to have a new moon happening in this area as well. The aspect of the new moon is the sun and the moon being together. When our luminaries come together, it means absolutely anything is possible. Absolutely anything is possible to begin here. In this fourth house area, your psychological foundation, your understanding of the world, your home, your family, real estate, properties, this idea of maybe a move or even just moving on, right? Freeing yourself from the past. You can plant these seeds of intention at this new moon. What do you need prayer for? What do you need a new vision for? What do you need new ideals for? Where do you want to express yourself or have a fresh start or a clean slate or a beginning here? Because this is Piscean energy in the fourth house, truly, where do you want to have new relationships or connection with women or feminine energy? Where in your Pisces energy do you need to just accept that maybe you need a little bit more downtime, solitary time for yourself now than maybe you did a couple years ago? Where can you ask for a fresh start or a fresh beginning to make that happen so that you have the balance that you need in your home life as well, okay? All right, Sag, I think it's going to be a good month. Thank you for having grace with me as I'm learning the new board and the new setup and the lights and all of that stuff. You know, you got to not be afraid to suck at something in public if you're going to try new things, right? So that's what we got going on over here. I hope you have a beautiful month. I love you so much, and I look forward to seeing you next month. Bye, Sag.